Yes, Rajvinder is to answer. He dashed the belt twice, but nobody dashed. Rajvinder? Dharya?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, he rang the bell twice, but nobody answered.
Yeah. So in both of the cases, past indefinite will be used. He rang the bell twice, but nobody answered. Okay, because if we talk about the situation in practical terms, and it could be only about the past time that we can say something like this. We cannot say this for the future. He will ring the bell twice, but nobody will answer. Okay, so that is not possible for future. It's possible for past only. That is why we can say this. He rang the bell twice, but nobody answered. Okay, now next statement is, I dash the door before he dash the bell. So the bracket words are open and ring. So be careful here, please. I dash the door before he dash the bell. Okay, only Gurpal. What about the others? Rajvinder? Rajvinder? Okay, Manavi.
Ma'am, I had opened the door before he rang the bell.
Okay, I'll tell you whether your answer is right or wrong. Wait. Yes, Jia and Janvi. Raise hand, Jia Janvi again. Yes.
Ma'am, I had opened the door before he rang the bell.
Okay, can you explain why you are saying I had opened the door before he rang the bell? Can you tell why past perfect here and past indefinite here?
Ma'am, because we use past perfect when there are two actions.
Yes, right. So why are you using past perfect here, not here?
Ma'am, because second action is done after that.
You are right, Janvi and Jia. Let me now explain it. So when there are two actions, then we are to make out like, did one action happen first and the second action happened later on? In this case, it is so. Here, one action happened first and the other action took place later on. So what happened first? First, I rang the bell. So this is action one. Then, because it's written like before he rang the bell. So before he rang the bell, I had opened the door. So action one takes past perfect and action two takes past indefinite. So I had opened the door before he rang the bell. Right? If I change the sentence now, next sentence, it is for you. You people all write down. I dash the door after he dashed the bell. Okay, all of you write the answer. I will check your notebook. Apply your mind as to what is the action number one. I dash the door after he dashed the bell. Yes. Here, what is action one and what is action two? Please be careful. Yes, all of you, please show me the notebooks now. Kanish, Gurpal, put your hand down. I will ask anyone. Kanish Pichai, show me your notebook and speak the answer. Kanish.
Ma'am, I opened the door after he rang the bell.
Okay, you are saying, please children, don't write the answer yet. If you've written, we are going to check it. But first, let us scrutinize whether this Kanish, his answer is right or not. So Kanish is saying that I opened the door after he rang the bell. So am I right, Kanish? You are saying this answer?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now you tell, like, how can two actions happen at the, did these two actions happen at the same place, same time?
No.
Then, what rule are we talking about? What's the rule? So this is wrong. Why is it wrong? Because you are considering that in both of the cases, the action took place at the same time, but it's not so. Something happened first. So what happened first? Yes, what happened first? Lavanya. Yes, Lavanya, give the answer.
Ma'am, first the bell was rung and then the door was opened.
First the bell was rung and then the door was opened. Yes. So what would be the answer then? Speak the answer, Lavanya.
I had opened the door after he had rung the bell.
Repeat, please.
I had opened the door after he rung the bell.
So you are saying I had opened and had rung, right? Is this what you are saying?
Ma'am, only rung, not had rung.
Repeat, please.
I had opened the door after he rung the bell.
Okay. So here it should be only rung. You mean rung is, you know, it's the past participle. It is third form. Is the past participle. Does the past participle come alone? No. The third form, that is the past participle, never comes alone. It comes only in the passive construction or with the perfect verbs, that is have or has or had. So there is neither has, have, had, nor is it the passive construction. So we cannot use rang alone. I guess you wanted to say rang, right? I guess you want to say this, I had opened the door after he rang the bell.
Yes,
okay.
Ma'am.
Okay. So Lavanya, you told me like this action happened first and it happened second, right? Right?
No. Ma'am, first the bell was rung and then the door was opened.
So what we use with the first action? Is it okay then? You are saying the right thing, that this action took place first. But here you are using past indefinite. Shall I correct it or not? Yes, come on. Lavanya has got a bit confused. Let us ask others. Yes, Janvi and Jia.
Ma'am, I opened the door before he had rung the bell.
But it is after.
Ma'am, after he had rung the bell.
Yes. So I opened the door after he had rung the bell. Because here this action took place first, after he had rung the bell. So first he did this, then this happened. So after he had rung the bell, then I opened the door. So first he rang the bell, then I opened. So remember the rule. And after means try to understand the meaning of after. So after he had rung the bell. Okay, so this action took place first. So when we had written before here, when I had written before here, then before means this action took place first. In case of before, I had opened the door before he rang the bell. Okay, let us do more example like this. I dash school before the bell dash. Now the bracket word is reach and ring. I dash school before the bell dash. Yes. All of you raise hand, those who know the answer. Yes, Tanveen will give answer now.
I had reached the school before the bell rang.
Yes, I had reached school. And you'll be explaining, Tanveen, why I had reached. I had reached school before the bell rang. Now Tanveen will answer why had here, why only past indefinite here. Yes, Tanveen. Raise hand again. Yes, explain.
Ma'am, because ma'am, I had reached the school. This is the first action, and before the bell rang, the second action. And always with the first action, we use had plus verb third form.
Yes, you are right, Vita. So, reaching school took place first. First, I reached the school, then bell went. Okay, for action one, past perfect. For action two, simple past indefinite. You can remember this by writing it down. For action one, past perfect. And for action two, simple past. Okay, and those who are not able to remember their tenses rules very clearly, they can also remember. For first action, we are to use had plus past participle. And for past simple past, we are to use second form of verb. That's a rule, okay? This is a rule. Please remember it. Okay, now next example. My sister dash her homework after I dash. The bracket word is do and do. In both of the cases, it is do verb. My sister dash her homework after I dash. Yes. Maneveet, Janvi, Jia, who else? Raise hand, please. Be active when you've done the work. Gurpal, well done. The moment your answer is done, please raise hand. That shows that you people are attentive. Please raise hand the moment you have done the answer. If you don't raise hand, it means that you are either sleeping or you have gone somewhere else. Because I know you might have all written the answers. All of you might have written. So if the answer is wrong, that's not the problem. Problem is being passive in the class. So these three children, afterwards, let me ask Tushar. Tushar, answer please. Okay, Raghav.
Ma'am, the answer would be my sister did the homework after I had done it.
Okay, stay here. My sister did her homework after I had done. Now, please explain why so.
Yes.
Now explain why. Okay, Gurshan will explain.
Yes, ma'am.
Explain, like, first you tell me, is it correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, then now explain why.
Ma'am, because my sister did her homework is the first section, and I had done is the second action.
Are you sure?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, let us again revise. Which tense we use for action number one? With action number one, we use past perfect. According to this rule, this is action number one. So with action one, because after I had done, she did her homework. So action one, first maine come here. Okay. After I had done, she did. So first action one will take past perfect and action two will take simple past. So Gurshan, you were confusing. Though you told me that the answer is correct, but the explanation is that past perfect goes with the action number one. Okay. So those whose hands are up, I appreciate them. And those who are giving answers also, unmuting themselves, a big clapping for them. The point is that this is how you show the teacher in the online class that you are attentive. The biggest reason for the online classes becoming a little failure is that children tend to become passive. Even when they are, you know, actively doing the work, they don't tell the teacher that they are active. So when you are active and attentive in the class, please don't hesitate in, raising hand or in answering or in unmuting yourself when you are required. That shows that you are sincere for the online class. Otherwise, this is a big facility for the students as well as for the educationists. Okay, only this much if you can do, you must do. And those who are not at all responding, I don't know what they are doing at that end of the house. Okay, now next sentence is one more sentence of this kind, then we'll shift to the other part. The doctor dash before the nurse dash. Okay, come and come. In both of the cases, the verbs are same. Now, those children who know the answer, please raise hand. If you know the answer, please raise hand. Yes. Yes. Three children have raised hands. Four, I mean, Janvi Jia, Gurupal, and Manavi. Tanveen also. Chaitanya also is raising hand. Yes, Chaitanya, give the answer. Ishani also. Yes, Ishani, you give answer.
Yes, ma'am. Yes. The doctor had came before the nurse came.
Repeat, please.
The doctor had came before the nurse came.
First, let us revise the forms of come. Ishani, tell me the forms of come. The first present form is come. Past form is?
Came.
And past participle is?
Ma'am, come.
What's the present participle?
Coming.
Yes. Okay. Now tell again.
The doctor had come before the nurse came.
Yes. Now your answer is correct. The doctor had come. Ishani, stay there. You'll be explaining. The doctor had come before the nurse came. Yes, Ishani. Now explain why like this.
Ma'am, because the doctor had come is the first action and before the nurse came is the second action.
Yes, the coming of doctor is first. How do we know this? Because it's written that before the nurse came. It means that before this thing, it happened. Before the coming of nurse, this happened. So this is action one and this is action two. And the rule says that with first action, we use past perfect. And with second action, we use past indefinite. Right? Okay, now let me bring a little change in the sentence, given sentence only. Suppose I say that, yes, Ishani, you can mute yourself. I can ask somebody else. Suppose I say, like, here I want not come. Okay. Now, what will be the answer for this? Not come. Yes. Okay, now two hands are up. Those who know the answer, please raise hand. Yes. If you know the answer, raise hand. Yeah, now even now Ishani has raised hand only. What about others? Don't put your hand down. Yes. Okay, now let us ask this Chaitanya. Chaitanya, yes. What will be the answer now? Chaitanya. Yes. Okay, let us ask, I guess there is some disturbance at his place. Dipali, yes, give the answer.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
The doctor had came before the nurse did not come.
First, you tell me what are the forms of come.
Come, came, come, and present participle is coming.
Okay. Then which form of verb we use with had?
Past participle.
And what is the past participle of come?
Come.
Then what did you say?
The doctor had come before the nurse did not came.
Again, okay, did not plus?
Did not come.
Yes.
Did not come.
So the answer will be before the nurse didn't?
So not come.
Didn't come. Though this sentence doesn't sound very grammatically beautiful sentence, but I just wanted to see whether you are able to use the word didn't. Okay, now next sentence is, now we'll be shifting the focus a little bit. Now, other kind of sentence. I dash when you dash to my house. The bracket word is prepare. Okay, I dash for exams. When you dash to my house, come. Now be careful, please. Yes, this answer has a... Okay, Krishna will answer. Yes, Krishna. Okay, we can ask somebody else. There is some disturbance at his place. Ritika. Ritika. Garima. Garima. Be ready to answer whenever you are attending the class. Lakshay, roll number 36. Today I'll be calling the parents of these children, those who are not answering. Roll number 36 I will call. Lakshay, Garima also I'll call. Okay, Lakshay, speak the answer. Okay, then this Jayant, unmute yourself, Jayant. Yes, children, let me first tell you, if you don't know the answer, it's okay. No problem. Just unmute yourself and let me know that you are there and trying to understand the thing. It's not always possible that you know the answers always. So be comfortable, relax. Not knowing is not a sin, but trying not to answer is a sin. Jayant, kindly answer, respond back. Ishika, roll number 22. Ishika. Okay, Gurleen, answer, beta. Gurleen. Okay, then this Nivedita. Keshav. Keshav.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, well done, bache. Keshav, I'm happy that you are at least there. Okay, good boy. Now the answer is, I dashed for exams when you dashed to my house. I was preparing for exams when you came to my house. One option is this. I was preparing. I was preparing for exams when you came to my house. Or you can also say, I had prepared for exams when you came to my house. Even that would not be wrong. But this is a better answer. I was preparing for exams when you came to my house. Because here when denotes that both of the actions are taking place simultaneously. So when you came, then it was going on. Okay, children, revise whatever we have done. And from tomorrow, try to be more attentive. And my special, you know, claps for those children who, you know, are spoke up, gave answers, and told me that yes, they are there with us. Okay? From tomorrow, please don't let me have a feeling that you people are not responding us. Thank you very much.